And now, for a limited time only, my listeners can use the offer code Justin to save up to 15% on their next brain surgery.
It's not a tumor.
Did you save your fish stick? Say yep.
Look at that puppy.
Hi, Uncle JD.
Okay.
It's a tumor, Dad.
It's a tumor.
It's a tumor.
It's not a tumor. Hey, JD, we just wanted to bring you up Emigration Canyon. You're probably only seeing straight into the sun right now, but just wanted to say we hope you feel better.
Honk, honk.
Love you so much, JD.
Justin, we are so glad that your brain surgery has been a success.
Yeah, and since the tumor appeared to be pretty darn near official PGA size,
we secured it from the hospital and had it solidified.
Now you have to make a choice.
Yeah, you can get it on, you can put it on your trophy shelf.
No, it's on your trophy case.
We don't care about that. It could be a shelf.
I wrote it, and
I
were just
spoke
supposed
it.
To...
Go ahead.
Or, okay.
You can put it in your trophy case.
Or see what you and Cooper can do with it off the first tee.
We are so glad the world will be seeing more of the Liz and Justin show for years to come.
Yeah.
Love you.
Me too.
So much love from everybody here, JD.
We love you, Justin!
Justin, my dude. Justin, and dude, what's up, buddy? Hope you're doing well. Hope you're progressing well. Just want to send my love. Thinking about you. And I can't wait till you kick this thing in the ass. And you're back here, hanging out with us at the shop. Fuck this corona shit. Fuck that brain tumor shit. You got this. I believe in you. And we'll talk soon. If you need anything, reach out, man. Take care.
Yo, Dibble, what's up? Just wanted to pass along a little note. When I started thinking about what I wanted to say, I started thinking about some of the memories with you, meeting you at Libby's wedding, and then you breaking me in mountain biking, literally and figuratively. I don't know if you remember me trying to keep up with you when I first started mountain biking and broke my shoulder. I think you probably remember that. And then me getting my ass handed to me on numerous occasions trying to keep up with you and Greg. So, going to Nemba Fest, camping with you and Becky a while back. But yeah, man, just some really good memories having post-ride beers and stuff. So just want to send a note to, you know, say our thoughts are with you, man, and much love, you know, in your recovery. You know, definitely a tough go. And, you know, but my thought is you're probably one of the toughest guys I know and somebody who probably has the most positive outlook to really kind of get through this. So I hope your recovery goes well, man, and can't wait to hang with you, all right? Much love, man.
Hey, Justin, we love you. We miss you. We hope you get well soon. We can't just wait to see you.
And dibs, once we're done with the snow, the murder hornets, COVID-19, and brain tumors, and we get baseball back, we can't wait till you can come back to the patio and have a good time with us.
Boo.
So, feel better soon, man. You got this, and we look forward to seeing you again.
Love you, Dibs.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey, Justin Dibble. It's Mrs. Leonard / Ottery. You knew me as Mrs. Leonard. I am just saying, get well quick. Be patient. So glad to hear you came through your surgery with flying colors. Anyway, now you're on the road to recovery, so good luck and God bless you.
Hey, man, I need your help. I need you to come back. I think I just made a very bad cocktail. I tried really hard. Also, getting distracted from the sidelines here. But honestly, dude, you're one of the most amazing people I know, and I hope everything's going well. I can't wait to see you again. You're gonna pull through just fine. I'm excited to get back on a bike with you, have beers, do everything. One of the funniest moments of my life was probably you and I riding ODB together, and I think I know you remember, and I hope we can dig out the GoPro footage of you just laughing maniacally behind me and exploding, and then catching me somehow in 2 seconds, every single, 30 feet. That was probably one of the funniest moments ever. But yeah, dude, honestly, we're here for you. Reach out, talk to us, send you anything you need. Yeah, we're here. Hopefully you can come home soon, and yeah, just, it's gonna be good. I'm excited to see you again, buddy. Take care. Talk to you soon. Bye.
Okay, where I go? Hi, Justin.
Hey, Justin. Mwah. Glad you pulled through it, buddy. We miss you tons. We're excited for you to get back with us, and got some shots now, and we'll have shots waiting for you later.
Yay, we love
Cheers.
You.
Dippa! Look at the camera. Look at the camera. Seriously, look at the camera. Okay, tell Dippo that you miss Dippo very, very much. Get better! Seriously, get better! Because nobody gonna tell me how elegant I am.
Hey, dude. Hope you're doing okay. Thinking all the positive thoughts for you. I don't know if you're religious. My mom is praying for you, which is so sweet. I have a funny story. I was hired almost a year ago on my birthday. Not hired. I was interviewed almost a year ago on my birthday, May 22nd, and you asked me what a bitter cocktail with gin was, and I got so nervous and I freaked out, and I said something with cucumber, and then I got in my car and I was like, shit, he just wanted me to say Negroni. And during quarantine, I made coconut wash Campari, so you should be very proud of me. That's that. I hope it made you laugh. Hope you get better soon. Miss you. Love you.
Hey, what's up, man?
Hi, Justin. We love you. Feel better.
Good to see you. Feel better.
Hey, Justin. Hey, I am so glad that you are surrounded right now by people who love you so much. And I'm so sorry that in this crazy time you're having to be in a hospital room by yourself. I wanted to reach out and say that I was thinking of you. You are always a person that I hold, you know, close to me when I think of growing up in Hopkinton. And I mean, we were always part of those circles on Christmas Eve gatherings, and yeah, you're an important person to my history. And I love that Meg posted a kind of a joke that she's like, oh man, you know, Justin's on a feeding tube right now and difficulty swallowing. Hope that gets better because he likes to eat. And I totally had a memory. I was literally sitting in Hopkinton High School's cafeteria, probably sitting with Dawn and Kristen and Casey and looking over. And you were like in the table in front of me. I don't think there was anyone else there. Probably every other person had finished eating their lunch and you were still eating. And I was trying to remember, I'm like, did he bring his massive lunches in a large paper bag or was it many paper bags? I can't remember now. But I'm wishing you much health and wellness and that you're getting to paper bag your lunch really, really soon. All right, take care.
Hey Justin, how you doing? My name is Dynamite Derek Dukes. I worked for a company called ECW out of Philadelphia. I'm a retired professional wrestler. I've known Lizzie for quite some time, watched her work, watched her train. I don't need to know you to let you know if you're good with Lizzie, you're good with me. Get well soon, brother. Pushing for you. Salud.
Hi Justin, my name is Megan. You've never met me before and I've never met you. And quite truthfully, I probably haven't seen your girlfriend in about 15 years. But we went to college together, and once a Kayo, always a Kayo. I just wanted to send you a video and say I'm thinking about you. I've been reading Liz's posts about everything that you're going through, and I really hope that you start to feel better soon. Keep fighting strong, and I'm sending positive vibes from Long Island.
Hey, Justin.
Hi.
We just wanted to say we're thinking of you, we love you, and we hope you have a smooth recovery and to see you soon. Unscramble those brains so we can do some fun motorcycle things in some years. All right.
You are not forgotten.
Me, Sarah, our friend B here, just hoping you a speedy recovery. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're feeling all right. Obviously, call, text, anything you want, anytime. I don't know. I'll talk to you soon. Be well. And, I'm sure you're feeling pretty much like Bruin is right now with all those pendants that get rid of you, so let it be.
Hi, Justin, it's Jill. We are so extremely happy that the surgery went well. That was the greatest news that I heard all week, if not all month. And I am sending you lots of well wishes for a speedy recovery. And I can't wait to see you out of the hospital.
Hey there, kiddo. I know life is not great right now, but just sending you a little Jew Chelsea love. You know, and was reading some stuff, some advice I was trying to think to give to you, but obviously, what the hell do I know? But I think Dr. Seuss here was pretty great, as I learned there are troubles of more than one kind. Some come from ahead and some come from behind, but I've bought a big bat. I'm ready, you see. Now my troubles are going to have troubles with me. So that made me think of you, because you know we don't take shit lightly, and you're gonna, you know, come out of this a lot better because you're you and you're amazing. And you know, it's just a little blip in the road. I think you're gonna look back on this, and this is gonna be a defining moment for you, and it's gonna be life before and life after. And I know for a fact that your life after this point is going to be amazing, because you've got Liz and me, and your health, you're finally going to, you know, feel a lot better once this is all said and done. This is another one I really liked. It's a weird book. I actually really like it though. It says, there are many reasons to be sad. You may be sad because you feel alone. The comforting thing about feeling lonely is that everything that has ever existed has also known what loneliness feels like, too. You may be sad because you are sad. It is okay to be sad, but if you are sad because happiness is fleeting, just remember that sadness is also fleeting, too. When you are sad, it is okay to let yourself be sad. That is okay. So, my little scrumpets of advice for you. I know you're expecting something hilarious from me, but haha, fuck that. Nothing funny about what you've been through, and there will be plenty of jokes once you're healed. So this was my, you know, hang in there, kiddo. You're loved, you're thought of. And as always, anything you need, I'm there. Get better, get some sleep. Love you, kid.